Right, so we're going to be talking about Deadpool, which we just recently went to see. And I have to say, I enjoyed it thoroughly. What about you guys?
Good fun.
Good fun.
It's really a lot of fun.
Good fun.
What made your what made it fun for you guys, though?
I'm not really big on films and such, but it was something that I could watch and not have to think too much about it. And I guess it kept fairly close to the lore of the character and that kind of thing. I don't know. It wasn't Spider-Man 1.
When you say Spider-Man 1, do you mean Sam Raimi Spider-Man 1, or do you mean Amazing Spider-Man?
Okay. The Tobey Maguire one. That one, okay. That one left me flaccid.
Really?
Yeah.
I liked it back in the day.
I never really got into it.
Yeah, he was a kind of a character that, give or take, should have played Peter Parker?
I think he was an alright Spider-Man, but not a very good Peter Parker.
Yeah.
True.
Because I loved the Spider-Man cartoon. I loved all that. But when it was the film, that was...
Yeah, they had to kind of make a backstory and make him slightly younger. Because I think the cartoon started off him probably in his like mid-20s anyway.
And he was in high school when in the cartoon. He just drew like he was 30. Yeah. Yeah.
He had muscles. He was big. He was bigger than almost Eddie Brock. So you think, this guy's in high school.
It's like the same thing with, the first Sam Raimi movie. Like, all of them obviously look about 35. Yeah. But they're all playing high school teenagers.
They've had to redo the same year for 3 years. They're now 30.
There's something wrong with the school. Everyone seems to be kept back at least 5 years.
The water is full of testosterone.
Even women are beastly in that. But it's true though. They did keep it straight to the source material with Deadpool, which that's what like everyone else loved about it, because it's everyone from Colossus. Do you remember the X-Men Colossus? Oh dear, like not just the first X-Men. He was a boy. I think he was an American boy as well, wasn't he? He wasn't even Russian.
it was because he was in X-Men 2 and X-Men 3 and Days of Future Past. He's in.
Oh, they actually
the same actor was in. Yeah, so three films. As an American. And, like, he, barely turned into... At least, like, in X-Men 2, he was only in... Had, like, one, like, little scene where he actually became, like, the metal version of Colossus. They've just... Weird that they have just totally rebooted the character. They've just totally changed him.
And using the whole time travel
reboot to just do whatever.
Well, they made him comic book Colossus, or the video game, or the cartoon Colossus. That's what I envisioned Colossus to be, and that was amazing. Yeah, it was amazing. When I saw him, I was like, oh, they've got Colossus in it. How's he going to be? He's going to be that little American kid. And then when he came out with that Russian accent, and he was gigantic, I was like, thank God.
I think the only thing was that you never saw him transform, like, because he's supposed to be a man that turns into metal.
Yeah.
And you only ever saw him as the metal version. Yeah. So this, because I think it's like the guy playing him physically wasn't the guy that did the voice. They used like one actor to do mocap and then another actor to do the voice work for him. They couldn't really have him be the same person on screen.
I mean, the whole point of Colossus is that he gets bigger as he when he changes. He's not the same height. He increases in height as well. So it could have worked, but maybe monetary problems, or they just didn't have the budget to actually show the transformation, or just time constraints.
They did a good job of with kind of costume wise anyway for this film.
Yeah.
I think out of all of the X-Men films, it's the only one where they actually took costumes from the comics. They did it a bit more like they do, like Marvel do with their own cinematic universe films, where they actually try to make them look like the real characters rather than just putting them in black leather.
It's true. It's the closest I've ever seen out of all the Marvel movies. Maybe when you said about Wolverine seeing his top, his uniform, and then going, "Are you joking?" That's probably yeah. That's...
There's that alternate ending for the Wolverine. He like sees his classic mask and gloves in a suitcase. They like hint that he would wear it some other time, but they didn't go through with it. But like the Marvel Cinematic Universe ones, they tend to like all of their costumes are pretty much like the comic style. Yeah. They're all like heavily based on that, but outside of like Marvel's own films, no one, you know, like Fox hasn't really done that, particularly with X-Men. They just never, they are definitely like movie versions. They're just like, yeah.
I mean, there's a reference to it in the first X-Men movie where Wolverine mentions something about running around in spandex costumes.
Yeah.
Mm. I mean, it's referenced, but I mean, it would look ridiculous. If it was done wrong, it would probably be done wrong. Back in 2000 something, it would look ridiculous.
I think if they tried it now, though, they could make it look good.
Yeah.
Costume designers have had enough time to, you know, practice at transferring the designs.
Deadpool and the Marvel Cinematic Universe is a testament to that fact. I mean, they're close approximations of the comic book costumes, and I love them all, to be honest. Mm. I can't find fault with many of them, or many faults at least.
I thought, like, from all the trailers, all of the trailers that came out showed it being this, like, action film, a lot of gore, a lot of comedy, you know, a lot of, like, crude humour and stuff. But then, like, actually coming to watch the film, I was surprised that pretty much half of it was, like, a rom-com.
Yeah.
It's also the fact that because of how little of it was actually action-y from what I was expecting, I feel like I saw most of what happened in the trailers. That was like a downside for me, because like pretty much every gag when he was dressed as Deadpool I'd seen in a trailer. There was only about like 3 or 4 jokes in the entire thing that I hadn't seen already.
Yeah, I kind
of would have been funnier if I hadn't watched any trailers.
Yeah, I think trailers have become, you know, you don't need to watch the movie now, just watch the trailer.
Yeah,
that's spoilers.
Yeah.
It's like with Batman v Superman, they've done all these trailers. One of them which showed like a big plot thing that I think they wish they didn't show. But then it's like they said, this is like they've done the final trailer. And they said, this is the last trailer we'll be doing. But now we've got 10 TV spots showing full clips from the film that are like stretched out parts from the trailer. It's like I literally feel like I've seen 75% of that film by now. And yeah, it's kind of, it's as much as like the, you know, like the Deadpool marketing campaign was really good. They didn't even have that many trailers. But I guess it just showed from like how little of the film was actually like the more action stuff in it.
Yeah.
They didn't have enough to spread out over multiple trailers, really.
Well, I'm guessing the next movie, obviously, there is going to be another one. They're going to probably learn from their mistakes, put less in, you know, into their trailers and actually have it saved in the movies. Because I never watched any of the Deadpool trailers, so that kind of like brushed over my head. So when I was watching it, I enjoyed every single moment of it. The rom-com side of it, I did like it. I know it's weird, and it's weird having it in a Marvel, especially with Deadpool as well, of all people. But it was kind of a nice thing to kind of make him kind of human. Because, you know, everyone thinks he's like this crazy mutant that you could just behead and kill and he would just revive and he just slaughters people. And for him to have like kind of a brighter side of his life. But come on, you knew when we watched it, you saw how sadistic their love was anyway. So, you know, so that's...
I think like the those scenes, I'm not saying they were bad, they were good. I think it's just there was, and I feel like I'd seen half the film already, but those bits were still cool. It felt almost out of place with knowing what Deadpool is like, though.
Mm.
Like outside of the film, where it's kind of the fact that he has a love interest is really weird.
Yeah.
At all, you know, it's not something you expect, but I think it almost meant that it's like held back from his crazy, because he's way more crazy in the comics. Like he's super sadistic,
because
he just doesn't understand
limits,
like what's wrong.
From what I remember of Deadpool, from what I've read, I mean, I remember him being pretty much any hole's a goal type kind of guy. So I mean, it didn't seem that far-fetched for him to have a love interest. I mean, he's had a few, hasn't he?
I don't know,
he was enamored with death for the longest time. I'm pretty sure he still is. I haven't read the comics in a while.
Yeah, but that's different to like having, you know, just a girlfriend that's a human.
Didn't he have, I mean, he's had, hasn't he had the long line I mean, I remember something with Domino, the mutant Domino,
yeah, but being like, a love interest
as well.
It's, but it's all like,
it's,
you know,
not his defining character. Characteristic yeah. Is yeah, I get that.
Having his story essentially be, I must save the girl, is a bit weird. Like, it's, you know, I mean, I don't want to get into spoilers of like how that ends up, but it's still kind of like, you know, it didn't end as how I was expecting it. A Deadpool film to end.
I probably understood the Ajax story of him chasing after him. That was probably, I don't know, even that's kind of far-fetched because he didn't really care about himself, did he? In terms of like cosmetically, he didn't really care. He just wanted to kill.
He was going after Ajax to, so he was pretty again because he didn't want to be ugly, which is fair enough.
Like you said, in the comic books, he never really took off his mask anyway, so he enjoyed wearing that.
He constantly took off his mask.
Did he?
Yeah.
He took off his mask to gross people out quite a lot.
Yeah.
So he loved the way he looked then.
Yeah, after getting used to it, I guess.
Can I bring up a point that when we got back from the cinema, something popped in my head. Do you think they could have made him a lot more uglier?
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah.
Because everyone was going, ugh, that kind of thing. And it was just a guy with a swollen face, you know?
He looked a bit more like he just had a rash.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was actually ugly.
Well, he had at least some sort of like third-degree burns. And then I can't believe the people...
That. It wasn't even a sort of, oh, good God, that looked painful. You know, it wasn't even like that. It was a, oh, I bet that itches.
Yeah, like he had a bad case of eczema.
Yeah.
That's true, though. The people were kind of overreacting. And also, in real life, you wouldn't really do that, would you? You wouldn't be like, oh, God, get off the street. Do you know what I mean? You know, hide in the sewer that you belong. Because, you know, the people must have some sort of, like, decorum or some sort of, like, you know, like, mindset going, oh, he might have hurt himself. Let's be nice and just look away instead of, like, staring. But he did walk through Chinatown. And it's notorious that Asian people will stare at you and not care what you would think. They will literally show you their feelings towards you. And you're like, can you be a bit more polite? They're like, no, we're just trying to be honest here.
That is true. Because you stare at me and Alan a lot.
Yeah. It's because you two are taller than me. You disgust me. I remember someone telling me that there was a genital shot. Did you guys see that as well in Deadpool?
Yeah. I saw brain base.
I missed it.
During a fight.
During a fight. Yeah.
Yeah. You see him get thrown and then you see, oops, there you see it.
Yeah.
I missed it.
Then it's good for you, you've missed it. But yeah, I was scarred for life seeing that bit.
Scarred for life. Jesus, that's an overreaction.
It's like,
oh my god, a penis!
And it's Deadpool's one, and it's probably wrinkly as his skin. Where was Stan Lee?
He was in the.
I know, I understand why he didn't see Stan Lee.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. Because he was looking at everything around Stanley, not at Stanley.
Everything but Stanley.
Yeah. I was like, oh, yeah, someone's dying, they're blown up. Oh, there's an old man. Let's look at somewhere else.
There's a particular scene where there would be a lot of things.
Oh, yes! I see. Now I remember. Yeah, that's true. I did get really distracted in that scene. So I definitely must have missed him.
That was a good cameo.
That's probably one of my favourites of his, to be honest.
As soon as he started talking, I just had to burst out laughing.
Apparently he really didn't like doing that one.
Oh, yeah.
It's like his least favourite cameo or something like that.
Yeah, I heard that he wanted to spend more time there.
Yeah.
That's what I heard.
And he was throwing real 50s as well. He's like, yeah, take it. We're actresses, don't throw it at us. Take it anyway.
I could just imagine him going up to the lady saying, are you a true believer? And throwing
Excelsior!
Money all over them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've seen the article now where he's saying, you know, his one problem with his cameo was he wished he'd spent more time.
Oh.
So he said he was in and out too quickly.
That's what she said.
Well, that was good. I thought it was the opposite. I was like, why would you hate that cameo? That would be my perfect cameo.
That would just be your film.
But yeah, I was quite impressed with all the cast because I don't think I hated anyone, even Ajax, you know, with his really Cockney English, which I liked. I liked his Cockney English.
I found that distracting at times, though.
Yeah.
That actor is actually English.
Yeah, which is good. Do you know what I mean? You don't want to get an American guy to do an English accent because it's just terrible.
Hold on. An English bad guy.
Oh. Crazy, right? I mean, they're playing all the superheroes at the moment. I guess they felt the need to cast one as a...
Didn't you watch the credits?
The opening credits were brilliantly done.
Yeah.
So good. Like, is one of those, you know, the surprising, like, subtle gags. Because at first it's just, oh, this is a really cool shot, and then you realise what's actually being written on screen.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
I did love that.
I'm surprised they didn't do, like, more fourth wall breaking.
That was one of my problems with it, to be honest. There were some great ones and some meta jokes that were pretty great. But
fourth wall inside a fourth wall, or the one about the professors?
Yeah, the professor one really got me. That made. But the little toy, it cuts to a little toy of the I don't know how spoilery this is going to be. It cuts to the Wolverine Origins Deadpool.
Yeah,
with the mouth sewn and everything, and I got a hearty chuckle out of me. Yeah.
But I was kind of almost expecting them to do like almost like movie stuff, where like it would break camera or like show a cameraman or something like that. Like, did it really do that kind of shit? Like, he can see the people on the set and the cameras and stuff like that, but other people don't notice or something.
Yeah, I'd like to have seen a joke like just ignore the cameras and the directors sitting there.
I think they got the balance right for the fourth wall breaking, because I think I was a bit worried going into it, thinking they were going to go too wacky, you know, when it gets to the point of where it's lazy. You can easily break the fourth wall by saying, oh, you know, everyone sitting in the audience, smell of poo-poo. But with the joke of Colossus saying, I'm going to take you to see Xavier, and then he said, are we talking about Baldy
or young?
Really subtle sort of fourth wall break. That was good. I like that.
Yeah, they were like just referencing the actors rather than, you know, saying Hugh Jackman rather than Wolverine.
Oh, yeah.
Stuff like that. That was good.
Well, obviously having his face stuck to his was a really great one as well. So it was like, they put him in it.
I mean, I guess it's all dependent on what camp you fall under, whether Deadpool can actually break the fourth wall and knows that he's in a comic book or a movie, or whether he's just crazy and he's just really on point when it comes to the references.
Well, we all expect him to be crazy, so whatever he says, you either take it as no or just think he's nuts. But yeah, like Nick said, it was perfect. I have to say, all the references and everything were amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was worried that he was going to just keep looking at the camera and talking to us every so often. he did it just a couple of times, and
he did it a lot. You talked to camera a lot. When he was alone, he talked to camera all the time. When he was in a scene with other people, he mostly ignored it.
It didn't get to the point of where I was thinking, oh, for fuck's sake.
I think obviously the main ones was kind of like from the start and him going backwards into his story of how it happened.
I think they did that pretty well.
Oh yeah, that was amazing from that point. You think it, because I was expecting, how did he become Deadpool? And then obviously from that point, that's when it starts to go backwards. And I was like, okay, so now they're gonna do it. Because too many films kind of like start at a point and don't really tell you anything. And I'm like, ooh, we need some sort of like origins with Deadpool at least.
Yeah.
I mean, it's origin, like how necessary origins are is dependent on like how popular the character is. Like, I think they did a good job of doing the origin story in this one, though, going back and forth between modern day and the past. Hopefully a lot of studios learn from that. You didn't have to wait till halfway through the film to get a decent action sequence. Just kind of went in guns blazing, and then
that is Deadpool now, isn't it?
Yeah.
So that fits it, just going guns blazing at the start and then throughout the movie. But
go for it.
No, I was just going to basically say about Angel Dust, which...
Gina Carano.
Yeah. I have to say, she's a really good character. And I probably would like to see her in the next movie.
Would you like to see more of her?
You wish Colossus' hand hadn't been in the way.
yeah. I wish I was Colossus at that moment. But yeah, you know, obviously having certain characters and liking every single character from the bad guy, even the good guy. You know, there's always in the movie, you hate someone in the movie. And I don't think I found anyone I hated in Deadpool.
Yeah, there weren't any bad characters.
Mm. No, yeah. All the cast was kind of like picked, hand-picked, and probably made the movie the way it is, because there's always going to be one rotten egg where you look at one person, you're like, oh, you've got to spoil the movie. You are definitely going to spoil the movie. And then this movie, it was like everyone from the bad guy, the good guy, even the taxi guy. Do you know what I mean? He was amazing. Yeah.
And he's good.
Yeah, it was like having him there. It was like kind of like breaking up a bit. And I was like,
yeah, with Angel Dust character, like Regina Carano, like I'm almost disappointed that she is playing such like a small character like that, because kind of, you know, she is a badass. She's, you know, she's like a really good fighter, like really strong woman. So it's almost disappointing that she isn't a more prominent character somewhere. Like, she could have been like a physically strong, like superhero type character or something like that, but they've just cast her as like a Z-list villain.
Yeah.
So it's, yeah, hopefully she does return for more Deadpool movies, and maybe like they make a bigger thing out of her character.
I mean, how much were their hands tied when it comes to characters that they could take from the universe?
The way it sounds is that Fox were kind of trying to keep it as separate as possible from the normal X-Men universe, like letting them reference it but not actually have full characters come over, because just in case it did bad.
Okay.
They didn't want to like either put the money into getting bigger actors to play the parts or whatever, or yeah, like tying it too close into those films. I guess now with like, now that Deadpool has made, I think now it's like 300 million, 400 million,
wow,
like a 58 million budget, so they're, you know, they're probably gonna
throw more money at the
next one. Yeah,
be more lex.
It's even just saying, like, because some of it, even like when he goes to the X-Mansion for that tiny bit, if like Cyclops opened the door and he was literally just in it for 5 seconds, I bet James Marsden would have done like a day on set to do that cameo.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Or if they'd asked him.
Yeah.
Like, he doesn't do anything else,
yeah,
really.
Yeah.
So he'd do it for free. He totally would have been up for it.
Just to remind everyone that he exists.
Hey guys, I'm Cyclops and I'm not dead anymore.
Yeah. There's not many superhero movies I would go to the cinema to see. But if, obviously, number two comes up for Deadpool, that's a definite that we'll go and see.
Yeah. I know they said they're not going to give it the next one a massive budget, but it'll get a bit more money. They won't have to do the origin story stuff, so you'll just get Deadpool for the entire film.
I'd like to think that they'd actually try and do it as a reboot at the start, and then have him say, no, this isn't a reboot, it's a sequel, baby.
Yeah.
And then Deadpool 2 across the screen.
So they just redo the origin story in a really over-the-top, emo way.
Maybe it's
gotta make it darker. I feel like the new executive producer, Christopher Nolan.
Leave it alone, Nolan. Leave it alone. Do not touch Deadpool. You know, just leave it the way it is. It's perfect the way it is. Don't Nolan-fy it. It's just, you know, everything that he touches, it's just like the guy who does Nightmare Before Christmas.
Tim Burton.
Yeah, with his stuff. You know, you just want a movie to be what you want it to be, instead of someone's own adaptation and his thinking on the way it should be. Because, you know, I love Deadpool. Like, you guys, you loved it because of the way it is. And, you know, I felt differently about the other X-Men because it was different. But I'm guessing you guys enjoyed the other X-Men, didn't you?
At first, I hated the original X-Men. I hated every minute of it. But as I grew older and watched it on subsequent viewings, it grew on me and I enjoy it a lot more.
Yeah, I really like the first two X-Men films. I mean, I liked X-Men 1 when it first came out. I think I was just young enough, like at the right age bracket or whatever, but I loved it. Loved X-Men 2. X-Men 3 was a travesty.
X-Men 3 was, I mean, apart from the whole cannonball
with
Colossus, apart from that, yeah, the film was awful.
Kelsey Grammer was perfect casting for Beast, though.
Yeah.
I will give him that.
Yeah.
There were some good bits in it.
But other than that, it was a terrible film.
I can't remember anything about 2 or 3.
Oh, 2's amazing.
It was amazing.
2's absolutely brilliant.
Who's still up there as like one of the best.
Oh yeah, without a doubt.
Superhero films.
I'm still a bit disappointed in Lady Deathstrike. That was Lady Deathstrike, wasn't it?
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I still think, well, again, it was a different time and probably something totally different about how I thought of her, because she was a lover of Wolverine, and this one, Wolverine didn't even know her. So
yeah, but
kind of weird.
They'd lost their memories. They both had their memories wiped. So it kind. They both had their memories wiped.
Is that what?
I'm assuming. I don't know. I'm just spitballing here.
Are you trying to defend this?
I the way I see it is they just don't have any memory of each other, even though possibly they may have met beforehand.
Yeah, I don't know if they're gonna like retcon Lady Deathstrike to be the woman that he was with in Japan, like it is in the comics. Take the woman from the Wolverine and make her Lady Deathstrike.
Maybe.
They're redoing a lot because of this time travel nonsense. Pretty much reboot, using the time travel to reboot the entire universe.
And that can only be a good thing.
Yes.
That is true.
Especially after number 3.
There was a 3? There wasn't a 3.
Yeah, it just went to the 4th one.
Yeah. It went back in time.
Isn't the 4th one Wolverine Origins? Another film
God.
That should be wiped from existence.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that was a terrible movie. Well, obviously, from that, they're going to make Gambit the movie.
Well, that's been... like, there's a bit of news recently that's been now, like, taken off the release list.
Oh.
Like, it did have a set release date that they were going to shoot for, and now it's been taken off that list, so I don't know what's going on. If they've decided to... I don't know if they're going to introduce Gambit in another film.
Okay.
To be honest,
maybe give him his solo film afterwards.
Despite how much I like Gambit, I don't think he'd work in a solo movie.
No, he's one of those characters that just works as an ensemble.
Yeah,
I don't think there's enough to him to make him, you know, an entire hour and a half even of just him.
I mean, it'll basically be him in New Orleans as a thief using his powers, and then that'll be it.
He might work in Deadpool 2.
Oh yeah.
If they made Deadpool 2 a bit more of a like an ensemble of random.
Everyone would work in Deadpool 2.
Yeah. But obviously with Deadpool, they will probably have all their original costumes. If any character dragged into the movie, we're going to probably see them in their original uniforms than really the leather ones. Because I could just imagine.
Well, Gambit wears a leather jacket.
Yeah, Gambit just wears like a long brown trench coat pretty much, or like a brown leather jacket, so it's not, as long as he's in the long jacket it'll be fine.
I thought it was a duster, like a brown leather
duster.
Yeah.
He wears a kind of weird face warmer, isn't it? The one
that balaclava.
Is it a balaclava?
Yeah, it is kind of. Yeah.
It's just like a balaclava with no face and the hair can come out.
It's not a balaclava anymore, it's a face warmer. from henceforth, it will be known as a face warmer.
It's just a face warmer. It just covers his forehead, and then kind of goes. Does it cover his ears? It does, doesn't it?
No, no.
It doesn't cover.
He's got little ear holes.
He's got little ear holes, so it just sticks his ears out. Yeah.
His hair and his ears stick out.
So yeah, he always kind of freaked me out with his get up gear. Yeah. Watch this space with Deadpool 2.
If it's anything like the first one, it should be a fun ride.
I think if anything, they can go further with it.
Yeah.
And they can do a bit more what they want now. They've got a bit more, you know,
leverage.
Trust with the studio. Yeah. Just how ridiculously well this film has done.
I don't know, but was Colossus and Deadpool ever in a team, or was this made up for the movie as well?
I don't know.
I don't remember them.
Not
being
in the comics
now. I think it's just they just picked a what they consider a B tier. X-Men to just put in the move, so there's some crossover.
Oh, okay. Because I thought there was probably a secret team that had them in it. That's why they were in the movie. Because I've never seen any comics, so I wouldn't know if there was a team that had Colossus and Deadpool together.
Yeah, I don't think he was. I mean, Deadpool has been in a team called X-Force. Yeah, I don't think Colossus was in it. I think I say it was just kind of like a character that they weren't going to be using anytime soon from the main X-Men films. They kind of wanted to do something new with probably the cheapest one they could get from the
I think it was a case of ones. Is it Fox who own X-Men?
Yeah,
they probably went to them and said, right, who can we have? And then Fox would go, let me just check, and they'll go through the file of facts of all the X-Men. So we've got Colossus and was it Super Mutant Death
Negasonic Teenage Warhead or something.
Come on, she was good. I have to say. I was surprised. I was because, you know, when you look at her, you think, what power does she possess, especially with a stupid name like that? And then, you know, to see what she does in the movie, you're thinking, yeah, she's obviously a charging character, so she's kind of
she's charging.
Is the hold back for 2 seconds?
Because yes. You know that's what I could think. Because you could say if you want to play, put them in the gaming speak, she's a charging character.
Is that why she crouches when she charges? Yeah. So she doesn't walk backwards.
So literally, she charges like someone holding the joystick back. It's like. Release now. So you know all her moves, she charges. So you know she doesn't actually do it spontaneously. She literally just ducks and does it for a few seconds and then releases it. So you know.
Deadpool, the casual show-o player.
Yeah. He's just the random one. He's just button basher. Deadpool's the button basher, while you've got Colossus, which is the strength fighter, like Zangief. Okay.
Yeah. Colossus is Zangief.
He's literally Zangief, and then you got. Sonic's.
She's Guile.
And then Deadpool is probably. Ryu? No. Ryu's a button basher, isn't he?
No! None of the characters are button bashers. How dare you!
Oh, we're talking Tekken now, aren't we?
Yeah, the equivalent would be like.
Dan, probably. Guerrero. He's probably Dan from Street Fighter.
No, oh, yeah, Dan. He's a bit rubbish.
Yeah, the one that the fireball only reaches, like, probably just about 2 centimeters away from him.
It barely. I don't even think it leaves his palm.
But yeah, you know.
Just lets off a firecracker in his hand.
Yeah. Or like a torch that he just presses. She's a good character. I enjoyed her.
Yeah. Hopefully, her and Colossus are back for the next one.
Mm. Yeah. It's
good. Yeah. More characters. Just some crazy mutant ensemble.
Hopefully, there's more mutants because the villains were good, but. Again, they weren't proper mutants. They were, like, modified.
There's a character called Taskmaster.
Yes.
They said that was originally who they wanted to be the villain.
Really?
They didn't have enough money to do it. They didn't have the budget for that. I guess that might be the one that they'll do.
Oh, that would be amazing.
He's the one with the skeleton mask, isn't it?
Yeah.
The Taskmaster, and he wears a cloak.
Well, his costume's kind of like an amalgamation of other people's stuff.
Oh, wow, he looks cool.
That's pretty much his power is essentially watches a move being performed and he can essentially do it.
Wow.
Muscle memory.
I think I watched.
I remember because he's pretty much got like Captain America's shield in like when he's in Marvel vs. Capcom.
He's like Skeletor.
Yeah.
Deadpool!
If they give him Skeletor's voice, best thing ever.
Deadpool!
I've been waiting for you, Deadpool!
Skeletor? The movie or the cartoon? Well, did he sound the same in the movie?
Get Frank Langella.
Frank Langella, yeah.
I'll be back.
Oh, man, that would be amazing. Deadpool 2 is actually the sequel to Masters of the Universe.
Dolph Lundgren.
As Cable. Yeah.
And Dolph Lundgren as Cable.
Cable He-Man. He-Man Cable, I think.
We're through the looking glass here, people.
Yeah. I don't think my feeble little mind can handle any of this anymore.
Yeah. I think I've blown my own mind. Who is Deadpool's top villain that he seems to like fight the most?
I have no idea.
I don't think he has one specifically.
Yeah.
No? Arch enemy. He has no arch enemy.
Just fights everyone.
I think everyone hates him. Everyone. Pretty much.
Yeah. Even pisses off the X-Men. Don't they fight him at one point as well? I think in one of the comics. To kind of like either just calm him down, they beat him.
I'm pretty sure his first appearance was in an X-Men comic, if I remember correctly, where he was paid by someone to assassinate one of the X-Men.
Okay.
I might be misremembering.
That sounds like Deathstroke.
Makes sense. I mean, it wouldn't be surprised if he was like, you know, his original appearance was something really small and it's like just supposed to be a really small one-off character. That just got popular enough that people loved him.
Mm.
Who doesn't love someone that's in the kind of bondage gear?
You just described every superhero.
You just referred to like most superheroes.
That's what I mean. Who doesn't love them? But yeah, a bit too tight for me, but.
You never know. You could rock it.
Rock it with my moves, yeah.
Can you take it in at the crutch?
It's going to be shielding there, I'll tell you that. But yeah, Taskmaster. For number two.
Oh. Yeah, I want him to appear. He's suddenly become my new hero. He's apparently he has made his debut in Ultimate Spider-Man, voiced by Clancy Brown.
I watched that episode.
Clancy Brown.
I actually watched that episode of Ultimate Spider-Man.
Was it awesome?
Yeah, he just imitated anyone's moves. Oh, he could imitate people's moves, his strength, everything. I forgot how he defeats him, but it took Spider-Man a load of turns to literally...
a load of turns. It's turn-based combat.
Hey, I talk gamer speak here. You know, out of everyone, I think I probably played the most role-playing games.
Taskmaster rolls a 12.
Yeah. Plus 2 against Spider-Man.
Spider-Man's waiting for his limit break to load up.
Yeah, Deadpool.
Deadpool.
Go see it, unless, you know, you're a child. And don't go see it.
Or a schmuck.
Wait, if he is. Yeah.
If you don't want romance, don't watch it.
If you're easily offended, don't see Deadpool. If you're not easily offended.
If you're easily offended, see it anyway.
Yeah. For the guys, it's the action movies. For the ladies, it's Ryan Reynolds' six-pack.
Well, for the ladies, it's also an action film. Because there's plenty of women that like action films. So, you know.
Man, I haven't met these girls.
It's not a stereotype here.
It's a good story. It just keeps going. It flows.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know how long it was, but it felt like it flew by, to be honest.
It's only like an hour and a half, I think.
Yeah.
Nah, it's a lot of fun. Yeah. Well worth a watch.